Welcome back. I described about the Hebrew Old Testament that was translated into Greek, known as the Septuagint. The second Bible that you should keep in mind in order to compare is what is known as the Masoretic text. This is even today considered as the official Hebrew Bible by the Jews. So they use the Masoretic text. The Masoretic text was prepared somewhere from the 7th century AD onwards. A group of people called the Masoras, they prepared these texts comparing with whatever was available, and that has been accepted by the authorities as the official Old Testament. The Jews still use the Masoretic text. So that would be the second one you must keep in mind. And the most important one, there is a third text that is found in the Dead Sea area. These texts that were found in the caves near the Dead Sea are some of them so beautifully preserved. Some are fragments, but for example, the book of Isaiah is almost completely there, all in scrolls. And the Essene community that lived there, their work was actually transcribing, writing, making copies of the Bible. The Essene community is mentioned by Josephus, a great Jewish historian who lived in the 1st century AD. He was a public servant of the Romans, but he is from Galilee. He knew the Jewish customs, and he has written a lot of things about the Jews. He has written even their history of the Jews. He has written, above all, about the Essene community. The Essene community was a kind of a religious group. They had their own manual of discipline. They had their own rule book. They would follow those rules, and they were at least partly celibate. They had times of prayer. Some of their prayer books are existing. It's a Thanksgiving hymnal. There is also a war scroll about the war they fought against the Romans. All this is actually narrated by Josephus. In that process, he has handed over to generations lot of information about the Jews, especially the Essene community. Josephus mentions actually of three sects in Palestine. The three sects are the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the Essenes. And he gives in detail the type of life the Essene community lived. As I already mentioned, they had their own rules. They had a sort of a community life. And they were mostly around the Dead Sea, living in the caves. And their main work was to transcribe the Bible. They wrote the Bible, copied the Bibles, and sold it, and that was their means of living. In that process, they have handed over a lot of documents to us. These documents were discovered in 1946 by chance. When some shepherds were grazing their sheep, they simply out of fun threw some stones into the cave, and that made some interesting sound, and then they went down and saw that there were jars with documents. They brought them out, they could sell it, make money, and then onwards the Israel government took over that area, and they began to search for whatever documents were available. Even now they are studying those documents and comparing it with the existing Masoretic text and the Septuagint. And interestingly, the Masoretic text is much later, 7th century AD. The only one that was existing was the Septuagint in Greek and its parallel Hebrew Bible. So they studied these and found that all the quotations they have used are actually from the Septuagint or its original Hebrew. In this way, one thing has become very clear. The Septuagint was popular, was known to the people, and the Essene community used that text as their original to copy and make more Bibles or copies of Bibles. Interestingly, there are many mentions of, for example, the children of light, children of darkness, and so on. These sort of expressions that are in the New Testament, seem to have a parallel in the Essenes' writings. There are no Old Testament parallel for these texts. Even the Son of Man and so on are not in the Old Testament, whereas in the Essene writings, they are there. No mention of Jesus or of John the Baptist and so on, but interestingly, there are many expressions that are found in the Essene writings and they are in the New Testament. In this way, we can deduce there must have been a very strong influence on the new Christians and the Bible, the New Testament that were written, let us say, in the first century AD. This way, that relationship is very strongly established. The Bibles that were available in the first century, at the time of Josephus, he mentions that there are three types of Bibles. One is the Pentateuch, that is now in the part of the Masoretic text, and that was known in Babylon. The text that was found in the Palestine area seems to be very close to the Samaritan Pentateuch. Whereas the Old Testaments known in Egypt are closer to the Septuagint. So these are the three traditions that are there, and maybe from AD 70 onwards, the way the Bibles were rewritten, they formed a certain common way of writing, common way of expressions and so on, and a certain standardization set in, and that is what now we are using. I'll stop with this. The next week's talk I will continue with the same thought, how the Bible in the Palestinian area continued to develop and was so beautifully preserved. May God bless you.